as a hero than to die as a coward. One man led the Igbos, the real Igbos, the Biafrans. He fought so hard, what do they do to him? They kill innocent Igbos and they chase him out of Nigeria. I will never allow anyone to chase me out of my motherland. Never. There will be no another Nigerian to be chased out of Nigeria by these old tagos, old kabas. We are tired of it. We are tired of it. Today, not today. I will send my message. My message will be delivered loud and clear. Even myself, I am more prepared than the way they are killing our innocent soldiers in Nigeria. They will kill our innocent soldiers outside. They will send them to go and fight Boko Haram without the proper gear. They will send junior officer, police officer to go and die on the road. Why the useless so-called Ibrahim Edris, the Inspector General of Police, Nigerian Police, corrupt Inspector General of Nigerian Police, we continue to loot and loot and loot and loot and loot and loot. And Muhammad Buhari just opened his eye. He opened his ear. He have ear. He doesn't hear. He have eye. He can't see. And you are thinking of running 2019? Ah, Baba Buhari, just go home in peace. Go home in peace. Go home in peace. There will be no Kaba. Not even Atiku Abubakar or Muhammad Buhari will rule Nigeria in 2019. Abba, wallahi talai. In the name of Almighty Allah, it will never happen. He does not matter. We are not going to allow you to win this election. Now the Channel TV has started it. This is just preamble, what is about to happen today. The message I am about to deliver to the whole world, this is the preamble. We are not going to allow it. Enough is enough. Few days ago, this is what triggered everything. Every action have reaction. Every action have reaction. I am a trained U.S. security personnel. Military family, United States Armed Forces family. If not America, I will be nobody. If not Almighty God who brought me to United States, Nigerian political leader would have turned me to armed robber or political thugs or kidnappers. God bless America and thank the good people of United States who gave me home, who gave me voice, who gave my family light, who gave us freedom. Who gave us the taste of how a country should be ruled? You can see almost all Nigeria in diaspora are supporting Omoyele because they know better. They have tested the world, how the world are supposed to be ruled. But those unfortunate, innocent civilians, Nigerians, police officers, innocent Nigerians combined with military, they have no idea. They don't know between the good and the bad. They have never left Nigeria. Either they left to Liberia to go and die, or they leave to Sierra Leone to go and die without no proper equipment. Even myself, I have more equipment better than the general in the army in Nigeria. You know what I'm saying? A whole single man will have one good equipment better than even the so-called the generals in Nigeria army, all because of corruption. Are you people, you coward? Share video you cannot share. Come out and fight, you cannot fight. Uprising you cannot do. Revolution you cannot do. Nothing you can do. You want mega comrade to do everything for you. I will do it. I will do it. I will do it because I am not a coward like you people. Look at you people. Touch even come a video to share. Every day they will keep telling you one word, one word, one word. And you will come out and call yourself a useless doctor, a useless professor, a useless master degree holder. Whatever. Pamphlet, educate degree, whatever you are holding. To hell with you! Enough of all those garden grammar. We don't give it to anybody anymore. Now it is time for us to take our country back. We are ready to take it back. We are sending a message. Let me tell you, PDP or APC, forget about it. Forget about it. If not Omoyele Sowore, it will be the youth. I don't care whether na Kislu or whether na Mogalu or whether na Dorotoyo, the Kolamo. You all should come together and work for the youth and for the people. Mega comrade, I don't want to be a president. I don't want to. charity begins at home. I want to start whatever I'm doing from home. I am a man from Igodo-Migodo land. I am a son of a dope state. And I will not shy away from where I come from. I am from Ewesi and Urenigbe in Oro local government. In the history of my local government, since 1975, there have not been anything that the federal government or state government have done for my local government. And we are the largest oil producing state local government in Edo state. And yet, we have nothing to show for it. Abuja, they are taking our money to Abuja to not. They are taking everything. Even Alpha to Kevet. They are taking our money by Adam Ali Oshomole, APC national chairman. Listen, when I call, don't fool. Listen, let me tell you, it's like a ticking bomb. The sleepy giant is about to wake. Ticking bomb, the clock is just counting. We will destroy all those mansions. We will destroy them. And there will be nothing left if you do not leave the power in peace. Revolution is knocking on the door in Nigeria. I am telling you, revolution is knocking on the door in Nigeria. I lost my mother-in-law a few days ago. I could not even go to Nigeria and pay the last respect to my lovely mother-in-law, all because of the political thugs, political criminals, political cabal, political terrorists. They continue to terrorize me, terrorize my entire family, terrorize my innocent children. Nigerian police are forced to be killing their own brother because of money. Nigerian young military officers are forced to go and fight a battle with nothing, with empty stomach. Nigerian young military officers are now taught to money-making machine. They will kill them and the hierarchy political cabal and hierarchy military, they continue to eat blood money. We are tired of it. This revolution is not we that is going to rise up. It is both the junior officers in the military, both the junior officers in the police, and both the junior officers in all security team in Nigeria. We will rise together, because if we don't rise together, we all will fall together. Nigeria is dead. Obasanjo and Buhari have killed Nigeria. Obasanjo and Muhammad Buhari have killed Nigeria, both of them. General Gowon boys, Gowon is there. Since 1960, almost 60 years, 58 years to be precisely, only two group of people, Obasanjo boys and Gowon boys, they did not allow peace in Nigeria. Instead, they turned oil producing, the fifth largest or sixth largest oil producing country, into the most poorest country in the world. Because you are scared. You don't want to die. Because you cannot talk, you have mouth. Because you are a fool. Because you are a coward. Because you allowed these old men to take your wife. They take your girlfriend. They take your money. They destroy your land. Everything they destroyed. And here they are riding Rolls Royce. Who will we start from? Dino Malaye. Senator Dino Malaye will be an example. If all Razi come, Dino Malaye will be hanged. Dino Malaye is our number one target. Dino Malaye, the youth who are supposed to carry everybody along. Dino Malaye, Senator Dino Malaye, who's supposed to carry the youth along. Instead, Dino Malaye turned the youth to become a laughing stock. Dino Malaye, he told you, Dino Malaye, I have not faced you. If you want to know me, go and ask Governor Godwin Obaseki. If you want to know me, go and ask Commissioner Gwendo, former Commissioner of Police in Edo State. If you want to know me, go and ask the current Inspector General of Nigerian Police Force, Ibrahim Edris. Go and ask. My headache is a migraine headache. It's a killing headache. I will continue to give you goddamn headache until you change. If you become irredeemable, we will pay for it. We are not going to allow our innocent citizens to pay for it. Last time you were in Atlanta, Georgia, Dino Malaye, I was in Georgia with you. Wait. After 2019, you refused to campaign for the youth. You come to America. Dino Malaye, send this message to Senator Dino Malaye. Nothing you can do about it. There's nothing. Your cup is full. You are a terrorist. You are a criminal. You are a political cabal. You are a political terrorist and you are a money laundering man. You are a looter. We do not allow people like you in America. Dere Malaye, you, how many times I call you? How many times? It is now or never. If you want to enjoy that, take that stolen property, that stolen money, you better just turn around and abandon PDP. Leave that fucking ship now. Leave PDP ship. There's no safe level for PDP. PDP and APC, they destroy Nigeria. They destroy Nigeria. PDP and APC, they destroy Nigeria. We are tired of it. We who can speak without fear of favorable, we are tired of it. And very soon after 2019, if you all manage to take this election from us, from among your election, we will show you where we are. We will show you. You will not come to Western world. Nobody, no political leader will leave Nigeria before the uprising. And there will be no safe haven for you. Let me tell you, a lot of people go online, they go on my page and call me a noisemaker. That is what angers me. Mostly. You call me a noisemaker, I will teach you what a noisemaker can do. I am making noise. I will make that noise until that noise will destroy your eardrum and eventually will kill you. Remember, the noisemaker in Tunisia, even a food seller, not even a noisemaker, a food seller light himself up in Tunisia. That is what led to uprising in Tunisia that toppled the dictator. Nobody is stronger than Mama Gaddafi. Nigerian, you don't be afraid of these people. They are coward. They are coward. Coward. If the tiger and the lion come back, can stop Governor Obaseki from coming to United States. If not because he came to United Nations, I would have thrown him in jail. Governor of Edo State. If not because he had what they call UN immunity. Whatever it is, when you come with the president, United Nations diplomatic immunity covered you. Obaseki would have been in jail today. I would have disgraced him. I would have humiliated him. I would have used him as an example to all the rest corrupt Nigerian governors. You can fool with others. What I read criminal justice, I'm a college dropout. I'm not ashamed of it. And I'm a security personnel. All I know how to do is to secure. I don't know how to I'm not a peacemaker. I will warn you. I will tell you the consequences of your action. Every action have reaction. I am a triple or quadruple counterpuncher. That is who I am. I am not trained how to defend. I am trained how to attack. And attack. I will attack until I die. My hands was tied a few days ago. Couple of days ago, my hand was tied by the Benin Royal Army. When I was enlisted to become Benin Royal Army Intelligence Division, a lot of people take it as a joke. You don't know Mega Comrade. If you know Mega Comrade, you will run. You will run with two legs. If you know me, you will run. You are lucky that I know the law. I know the button I will hit. I know the button I will not hit. My problem is not a problem you want. When I play with you, I respond to you. I love you. If I don't respond and I don't play, let me tell you, you will go down. You will go down just like Saddam Hussein go down. Just like Mama Gaddafi go down. You will go down. Nobody mess with the tiger and the lion and go free without bruises. The bruises of freedom, you will feel it. The hammer of freedom will hit you in the head. Let me tell you, how the hell will you come to America to come and enjoy the land of freedom? To come and enjoy infrastructure? To come and enjoy good road? To come and deliver a baby? You use my taxpaying money, my family taxpaying money. You come and enjoy it, you will go home. All these Nigerian superstar, all these Timaya and the rest, all your houses, them Peace Square, them all those people that refuse to support my election, that are singing for PDP now, your house when uprising come will be our number one target. We will burn it down to ashes. We will destroy it. Hence, you people refuse to join us and fight for us. We are the sleepy elephant. We are the sleepy giant. Let me tell you, I am not fighting for myself. I am made. I am made. I'm not fighting for my children. My children are already in U.S. military. They can never suffer for the rest of their life. as a father of a U.S. Air Force intelligence officer, America have covered his land. I enjoy the benefit of U.S. military. How come even those that are in army in Nigeria, their wives, not even their children, enjoy the benefit of Nigeria army? Why? Oil producing country. Will you ask that question, fools? Fools! Will you ask that question? We have not even started.